sign.
Do what you can. This cannot.
Children, don't name the dead children, don't remember the dead children, don't think of the dead children, don't even say dead children. This is how they think. Thank you.
Say the numbers were about 25,000.
I would say more than that. I mean, only just has the flow of people stopped. People are still trickling in. We need to make sure that everybody does know that there are protests and demonstrations happening across the UK, from Edinburgh all the way down, all the way west to Bristol, Birmingham, Manchester. All the major cities have got their own protests and demonstrations happening. So this number is incredible. Absolutely amazing turnout. The atmosphere is electric. People are here with a very powerful cause, for a very powerful cause, and they're doing a great job getting the word out. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker, you've seen him on telly, heard him on the radio. There he's funny, but today he's serious. Jeremy Hardy.
Thank you very much. As the previous speaker said, there are many differences here. We come from different traditions, different cultures, different religions and no religion, and with different politics. We've all got our own ideas about history, about the future, about what the map of the Middle East should look like or what it will look like. Some of us have got different ideas about what the solution is. Some of us are even giving up hope that there will be a solution. Today is not the time for those differences. I'm not here to pontificate and give you my theories. I'm here to stand with you in humble solidarity with the people of the Gaza and the people of West Bank and the people protesting all around the world. I'm here to stand in defiance of my government, of the Israeli government, of the American government, and of the Egyptian government.
I'm here because I just feel responsible as a British citizen for what my government is doing, supporting Israel with arms and with moral support, and I feel that we have a responsibility.
How hard is it for you to kind of voice your opinion without being backlash, or how important is it?
It doesn't even get on air for the most part. I can make comments about Israel on the radio, but not many of them make it through, to be honest. People are realising there's protests going all over the world, and I think our leaders are realising that, you know, it reflects badly on our leaders, and that, you know, quietly behind the scenes, maybe they're saying something. Maybe John Kerry is saying something behind the scenes. Maybe there is frustration. But that's all, what else can we do? We can boycott and we can protest.
And if you can say anything to Parliament or powers that be, what form is the message that you're trying to get?
There need to be sanctions against Israel. There need to be EU sanctions against Israel and stop its privileged relationship. Israel is basically part of the EU, except it doesn't have to abide by any of the human rights.
Same reason everybody else is. I just see an intolerable situation and my country is supporting it. So I want to register the fact that I'm not the Gaza incident has opened a lot of people's eyes, because they've realized that the Israelis really are like the Ku Klux Klan in a certain way. You know, they're ruthless and they're racist. By the way, I don't mean all Israelis. I met a lot of very nice Israelis in Israel, but they don't happen to be in government. It's for our MPs to realize that a lot of people care about this, that we can't carry on slipping weapons to the Israelis and turning a blind eye, even though there's a huge amount of pressure to do that. I suppose we want to be as strong a lobby as the Zionist lobby is. We want to be...
I'm here to stand in solidarity with the Palestinian people on behalf of the Irish people. When we were beleaguered by our oppressor, the Palestinians stood up with us. We are here today to stand for the Palestinian people, to demand an end to the shelling, an end to the bombing, and demand that international powers take action against Israel and ensure that the bombardment of Gaza stops immediately. I do think they will, and they'll put pressure internationally on Israel and on their allies, one of whom is Britain. So the fact is that Britain are exporting weapons to Israel. That has to stop. We have to organise a boycott against Israeli goods. These are the kind of civil actions that ordinary people can take to try and end the brutal oppressive regime in Gaza and the genocide against Gazan people. We have got to take action immediately to end the suffering of innocent men, women and children in Gaza and in Palestine.
It's the biggest demonstration so far, and we're going to carry on demonstrating as long as
promise that freedom for the people of Palestine.
To me, follows a great Palestinian, a great person who's such creativity, such entertainment and such voice. And I want to say in conclusion, tell the British government, act in our name, not in the name of the arms manufacturers. I say to the British people, your voice is making a difference. Our government is getting more and more isolated. And it's a pleasure to be followed by such a great Palestinian as Reem Gilani. Thank you.
I'm going to celebrate Palestinian culture.
Ya halali ya mali. What I have is mine by...
And trade union activists and the PCS in Barrack UK. And this is the poem that I read at today's rally. It's called Free Palestine, What If the Children Were Yours or Mine? This is a massacre of the people of Gaza. What if those children were yours or mine? Would you join the cries of Free Palestine? Wake up every morning to the news of more lives taken. Children, bloodied bodies and faces, whilst a distraught mother embraces, knowing they will never study or play, their lives brutally taken away. This murder of innocent people can only be described as evil. Several hundred dead, including children and babies, a shocking average of 8 children killed daily. And each day the danger increases as the death toll horrifically rises. The silence of the media speaks volumes, but the sound of our collective voice shames as people of every race, age, religion participate in global protests taking place. Muslim, Jewish, Christian and more, shoulder to shoulder, in solidarity, united in anger. Biased broadcasting company reports are dishonest, but as hundreds of thousands of people protest, cities are forced to a standstill by the strength of solidarity and can no longer be ignored even by the BBC. How can anyone whose known persecution and genocide seek to wipe out another taking innocent lives, how can freedom for one equal taking another's freedom? Murder of the innocent is not how liberty is won. How can governments be impartial, stand by silently, devoid of responsibility and humanity, whilst each day the destruction by disproportionate war injects innocent people with its horror and instills fear? Free Palestine is what the voices cry at demos around the world, responding as more die. As Nelson Mandela stated to the people of Palestine, your freedom cannot be separated from mine. Until you are free, we cannot be free. We must never forget but learn from history. How can anybody whose foreparents were the victims of fascism now be the cause of apartheid, displacement and racism? This is a massacre of the people of Gaza. What if those children were yours or mine? Would you join the cries of Free Palestine?
I'm here because I'm outraged at the oppression and persecution of the people of Palestine and Gaza and the killing, indiscriminate killing and killing with impunity of young children.
It was essential to be part of a demonstration which is insisting for the second time now in a week that the 18-day bombardment and attack on Gaza is an unacceptable barbarity. Understand that it's not just about the state of Israel. The state of Israel couldn't do what it does if it weren't supported by the United States government and by the British government. So we are right at the heart of this problem. We're not peripheral. The pressure of the anti-war movement now over the last decade and more has had a huge impact both on public opinion in this country and the decisions that the government is able to make. Remember, it's only a year ago that the British Prime Minister failed for the first time since 1782 to get a vote for war in the House of Commons when he wanted to attack Syria. I hope that we can build a similar momentum to stop them supporting the State of Israel. Stop arming, supporting and funding the State of Israel.
I believe in humanity, and I think that most of the world doesn't want what Israel is doing to Gaza and to the Palestinians, and I stand for humanity.
If you look at the way that the media portrays the state of play within the State of Israel day to day, it's sickening what they convey and what they fail to relay, for they say nothing of the sales of weapons coming from the USA. A shock and awe campaign, all in the name of self-defense. It's nonsense, this pretense, this pre-assembled semblance. An Israeli attack is a daily occurrence, and the fact is that the people are reacting as a consequence to a relentless charade, a blockade that blocks aid, with innocents defenseless from a senseless barricade. But for every small defeat, every bullet-ridden street, for every person they mistreat, harmed by the armed elite, for every town made obsolete by every single block of concrete, this is a project that will never be complete, because the missing piece is peace. It's time to follow our hearts and not orders, to build bridges, not borders. Problems are solved when both parties involved are willing to participate in a debate without killing. How many lives does it take to stop the blood spilling? When fundamental human rights are systematically denied, it's no wonder fundamentalists decide to take their lives by committing suicide. David Cameron, what if you had grown up in a school that was blown up and nobody had shown up with tools to rebuild? Or you had watched as your entire family was killed? Would you ever shake the sound of soldiers' footsteps on the ground as everything you loved was taken with a single round? Walls installed to segregate will only generate hate and never separate the people from the problems they create. The weight of the mortality rate rests upon the state and all economic sponsors since 1948. And with a million civilians reduced to refugees and a Gaza stripped of its rights and liberties, it is time that they addressed and pressed these problems overseas. Because for every small defeat, every bullet-ridden street, for every person they mistreat, harmed by the armed elite, for every town made obsolete by every single block of concrete, this is a project that will never be complete. No, the work will never cease, because the missing piece is peace.
Children and the people's lives, structured by the walls, but you don't realize, for all the hurt and all the pain, their lives will never, never, never be the same. No, can't see their families no more. Kids crying on the floor because they lost their daddies, their families. They don't know what to do, and we don't know how good we got it.
That supported today's demonstration. Palestine Solidarity, Stop the War, CND, Muslim Association of Britain, Friends of Al-Aqsa, everybody that's come together.
I see destruction and poverty, still nobody wants to know. I see kids on the streets with nothing to eat, still nobody wants to know. I see destruction and poverty, still nobody wants to know. Nobody wants.